everyone, welcome to the My Emotions Matter podcast, where we discuss ideas on knowing oneself, improving relationships, and living a life of purpose, all under 10 minutes. This podcast is brought to you by My Emotions Matter, an education company that creates self-reflective learning experiences to develop emotional intelligence in students, teachers, and working professionals. To know more about us, visit our website, www.myemotionsmatter.com, and also follow us on our social media handles. I'm your host, Sagar Satyal, and if you've been a regular listener and if you're wondering, your intro sabai kina maile matra bhaneha bhanera chai, as I say, I'm the only one hosting the show, but I have a guest with me, tara guest bhanda pani she's part of the team, but I think she's making her first appearance in the podcast, if I'm not mistaken, yes. So, let's welcome Aprajita Jha. We call her AJ. She is linchpin at myemotionsmatter.com, but that also makes sense. So AJ ko barema quickly bhannu parda chai, AJ has been with us ever since we started My Emotions Matter. Yo bhanda agadi pani bhavnar mero emotional intelligence ko projects harma she's been part of it. My Emotions Matter ma chai AJ ko kaam bhaneko chai everything ho khasma. That's why her name is Linchpin. She's very crucial to whatever we do. So this includes content development dekhi lera, content design, facilitation. And yeah, it's a startup, so everything, right? So AJ, welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you so much. It
feels so formal to introduce you this way, right?
Yeah.
So as I say, AJ lai lyaunuko one of the main reasons is because if you've been following our podcast, we've been talking about closing chapters in life, yeah. Jo chai hamle euta theme pakdera agadi badhirachhau, and aajako topic is about giving up in the right time or giving up in the right moment. So we just thought there would be no other person better than AJ to talk about this with, because AJ ko life ma chai she's been through a few things. She's had to, you know, she pursued something, she changed the trajectory. So sabai maile aafai bhanu bhanda pani, I think briefly chai, I think AJ, if you can just, you know, tell our listeners about your journey so far, and then maybe we can dissect that a little bit.
Yeah, sure. I think this feels very nostalgic whenever this is brought about in conversations, but I think it has been one of the most significant parts of my life. Mere lagi chai, whenever it comes about like discussing about dreams or like maybe quitting goals, like I can relate it to my own experience, like after my plus two journey. So I had always wanted to be a doctor since I was a very young kid, and right after my plus two, like I was giving, I was taking coaching classes and I was giving entrance exams, one after another. So in that process, like I really wanted to like go after that dream. So I took not just 1 year, not just 2 years, but 3 years continuously to strive for it, but only to realize that that was not something meant for me. It was not my cup of tea. So त्यो तिन वर्षको आई थिङ्क स्ट्रगलले चाहिँ टट मी अ लट अबाउट लाइक वाइ इट्स समटाइम लाइक बेटर टु गिभ अप रादर देन गोइङ आफ्टर द सेम थिङ अगेन एन्ड अगेन.
राइट, ओके. सो ओभियसली 3 इयर्समा त्यो हुन्छ नि, मैले यसो सोच्दाखेरि चाहिँ एज एन आउटसाइडर लुकिङ इन, 3 इयर्स द टेम्पटेसन इज कि यत्रो 3 वर्ष त गरिसक्यो, वान मोर इयर मे बी नाउ द नाउ माइट बी द राइट टाइम, अर यु यु लुजिङ आउट अन सो मच भन्ने थट प्रोसेस जान सक्छ नि त, होइन? सो हाउ इज द्याट process like for you to navigate that? Kinabhane, yeah, it's not just about you, it's about your family. In Nepal, it's about extended family as well. They're always going to have an opinion. Kina chhodna lai yatro garisakepachi loss huncha, why you have to start from scratch, which of course you did as well. So the whole thought process, kasto thiyo?
I think when it came to my family dynamics especially, like my parents were like very supportive in this case. Because maybe there's a different sort of pride associated with being called a doctor's parent.
Yeah.
So they kept like supporting me until the last. And maybe if I had more like a practical, like, you know, support system around me, I would have realized that I should have stopped like striving for something so unrealistic, like time and again. Because I'm not saying that dreaming it was a bad thing, but I think I should have realized that after a point of time, it was just getting like repetitive and it was not turning into something practical. You know, it did not give me some kind of good result. So I think two aspect might say, although I was trying a lot and I did have supportive people around me, I had no like practical check and balance to be actually reflecting upon my own experience. I mean, त्यसले गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ एट वान पोइन्ट अफ टाइम इभन इफ आई वान्टेड टु डु सर्टन थिङ्स माई एफर्ट ह्याड लाइक सो पास द लेभल अफ द रिजल्ट द्याट आई वुड बी गेटिङ फ्रम द्याट एफर्ट. सो आई थिङ्क इट वाज भेरी मच अफ एन इमोसनल बर्डन फर मी टुवर्ड्स द लास्ट. सो आई थॉट द्याट एट वान पोइन्ट इट वाज लाइक okay to give up rather than just striving for it again and again.
Okay, I think that's really well explained. Mala aile aira chai, I'm not interviewing you, tara idhai questions aira chai ke mala chai, because afai ma chai, so you gave up on this journey and then you
Yeah.
joined King's College, right? And obviously, in a way, you were in a class where you probably had a lot more maturity than majority of your classmates, because of, because of multiple factors. अब एउटा चाहिँ अलिकति एज ग्याप पनि अलिकति हुने भयो 2-3 इयर्सको होइन, एन्ड प्लस आफ्टर एभ्रिथिङ द्याट यु बिन थ्रु, त्यहाँ जाँदाखेरि चाहिँ त्यो ट्रान्जेक्सनमा इट्स सो इजी टु फिल फ्रस्ट्रेटेड द्याट यु नो म कहाँ आइपुगेँ जस्तो हुनसक्छ होइन, अर वाट कुड हेभ बिन, वाट इफ स्पट्सको कुराहरू धेरै आउँथ्यो होला. सो त्यो बेलामा चाहिँ हाउ डिड यु म्यानेज युर सेल्फ, बिकज मैले किन सोधेँ भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ अल दो वी आर टकिङ अबाउट युर जर्नी स्पेसिफिकली, आई थिङ्क फर एभ्री वान लिसनिङ, 2020 स्टार्ट हुँदैछ एन्ड यु नो if there's a career that you pursued but it's not going well for you, to change garna like the switching cost aai jasto lagcha ke ab kahan yo chhodera arko domain ma ta ma bottom bata start garnu parcha huncha ni, people my age are already at a level and we continue to persist in that path even though we know ki timlai bhane jasto burden aba dherai huna thalisakyo haina, aru le ke bhanla bhanne kura le nai hamlai drag garera huncha ni tyo in the wrong path even though we know we should be giving ourselves a better chance of switching. So how did you navigate that kind of a transition?
I think that's a really nice question. I think mero case ma chai when I joined Kings and I started the undergrad journey, like for me, I think one thing that made it easier for me to navigate the thing was previously if I had, like, you know, done my plus two and gone into a college, or even if I had pursued MBBS for that matter, I think I would have still done it with a feeling that I'm doing this for my parents somehow, because this is something that, like, you know, my parents have given me so many years of education only to, like, just for them to see me, like, keep climbing on.
Right.
But I think that would be some sort of attribution that I would have had if I had joined, like my college education right after my plus two. But I think the 3-year gap that I had, I think it somehow made me realize that whatever I have to do now, it would be for myself and nobody around me.
Right.
Not even my parents, not even somebody who I would, like, go on to be with in the future. So I think that sense of, like, that sense of doing something for yourself really, like, you know, amplified in me when I joined my undergrad journey. So I think in that case, even though I felt that difference between me and other people in my class, and even if I could see that, I'm not saying that I was more mature than them, but I had different perspectives to put forward.
Right.
So I think in that case, like, that sense of, like, you know, that I'm doing this for myself and nobody else, I think it kept me sane throughout the journey and it made it quite easy for me to navigate that.
Okay,
so, yeah.
I think what I gathered from whatever you just shared is ki self-awareness is very important. So, and a lot of times ki we do things for other people. As a Biana Bahar, when I was doing my normal everyday reading, and this one, what are a few things that make us feel like we should do certain things? One, there is money, thio, a sense of approval, thio, sense of guilt, to avoid punishment.
Yeah.
I should, one mentality, we end up doing things that doesn't enrich our life. And
yeah.
I can do this, I'm doing this because, so as a tax officer, I preferably I would not have liked to have gone there. But after me, it's a privilege because I go there and I do that, I do it because I get to run my own company and work on something that I'm passionate about. And I think your mentality, like, the switch karne kura chai, I think is very interesting. Timle bhakar share gareko yahan chai, haina? Other than that, I think timle bhane jastai, like, afu lai kile joy dira chha, haina? Yo ma last podcast ma ni bhanira thae, 2010 ma 2020 kahile aayo kahile sakina thaha chaina, time is just flying by, haina? And if we keep on doing things just because we feel we have to, because we already started it, then ani yaha chai kati bela chai mancheharule yo garnu hudaina यस्तो पनि भएको थियो होला तिमीलाई, होइन, गिभ अप नगर, डोन्ट बी समवन हु गिभ्स अप भनेर, यस्तो एकदमै रेजिलियन्सको कुराहरू भएर आउँछ नि. तर आई थिङ्क बिङ एबल टु स्विच द पाथ विदाउट गिभिङ अप अन युर सेल्फ, आई थिङ्क द्याट्स इभन मोर क्रुसियल जस्तो लाग्न थाल्यो कि. अब चाहिँ द पाथ क्यान चेन्ज, होइन, बट इट डजन्ट नेसेसरली हेभ टु मिन द्याट यु हेभ टु कन्टिन्यू डुइङ वट यु थट यु सुड बी डुइङ. मैले चाहिँ करियर पाथलाई नहेरिकन वान थिङ द्याट आई बिन थिङ्किङ अबाउट रिसेन्टली इज कि हामी आफूलाई पनि धेरै बक्सेसमा राख्छौँ जस्तो लाग्छ कि म यस्तो मान्छे हो, होइन, यो बाहेक म केही गर्दिनँ खालको. सो आई थिङ्क कहिलेकाहीँ चाहिँ इट्स जस्ट बेटर टु सी द्याट युर इन अ बक्स एन्ड जस्ट कम आउट अफ द बक्स, बिकज यु नट अ ट्री, राइट? यु life is more dynamic than that. So if you don't like where you're at, you can always move. This is one quote that I really like. We're not trees, you know, and sometimes it just takes a little bit of listening to other people's stories, perspectives, to just get that idea. So फाइनली चाहिँ अब हेर्दा हेर्दा 10 मिनट सकिन लागिसक्यो होइन फर द बिकज यु अलरेडी मेड दिस स्विच एन्ड आई नोन यु फर लाइक 4 इयर्स नाउ अनि यु आर वन अफ द मोस्ट थटफुल पिपल आई नो अनि यु फाइन्ड जोइज एन्ड लिटल थिङ्स एन्ड इट जस्ट सिम्स टु मी द्याट यु जेन्युनली पुट दोज थिङ्स बिहाइन्ड यु अफकोर्स कहिले काहीँ त्यो थट आउँछ होला बट आई डोन्ट थिङ्क यु लेट इट यु नो स्टे अन युर माइन्ड फर अ लङ टाइम एन्ड यु जस्ट लेट द्याट गो होइन सो इफ देयर इज एनी वान कन्टम्प्लेटिङ कि सर्टन थिङ्स द्याट दे आर डुइङ राइट नाउ त्यो चाहिँ स्विच गरौँ कि चेन्ज गरौँ भने चाहिँ एनी फ्यु यु नो टिप्स अर यु नो सर्टन थट प्रोसेस द्याट दे कुड use so that the transition becomes easier. Anything you want to suggest?
I think last week I was having a conversation with one of my juniors back in school. She contacted me after many years, and she's also trying to apply for US, and she was asking me whether it's okay to do it for another year or she should quit doing that or joining something else. So she was just asking me the same question, you know, when is it okay to give up on your goals, or when is it practically fine to be giving up rather than, you know, just leaving it and running away. So I was just thinking about the same, and I think it's okay to give up when you think that it's practically impossible to do anymore after whatever you've done, because after a certain point of time, it just saturates and you cannot do more than what you've done in the past.
Yeah.
And then it just becomes an emotional burden for you in the long run. So it's necessary to differentiate that. It's necessary to find out what's the maximum capacity until which we can keep trying, after which it will become an emotional burden and we have to quit thereafter. And also I think it's also okay to quit when it starts to take a toll on your personal interests that you have in life and also your relationships. I think in my case it happened quite a lot when, because I think in the 3 years I was so much into my goal that I'd started stopped doing anything that I liked, and I stopped visiting all my friends, so it made me into a really isolated person, which I really did not want to be. But I only realized this after some years had passed by. So I think this would be it.
Yeah, my quick reflection is ki jay decide gare pani, I think at the end of the day it's on you to justify that decision. And as long as you make a good story out of it and live with that idea ki I've become a better person because of this experience, I think that's fine. Just to feel pani bhayo haina. So thanks EJ for sharing your insights. We hope to have more of your insights in the days to come. Your podcast mate, we're just trying out different formats, you know. If you've been listening to us for a long time, you'll notice this. So yeah, there you have it. That 2020 started on the last side, 2019 coming to an end. Again, there's a lot of debate about the decade kali start hune kali end hune. For me, from a motivational perspective, I think 2020 must start hune. just makes sense, just makes it easier, right? So just, it's up to you how you do it. But yeah, we really hope ki as a cool podcast give you a food for thought ki if there is something that's not serving you, emotional burden basi bhairacha, then the perceived benefits of what might be in the near future, maybe it's time to just change the path, because you're not a tree. So yeah, having said that, we hope you have a reflective time ahead, and we'll be back again next Tuesday at 8. And until then, see you and have a great week ahead.